Hi students, in this video we are going to see about the mean, variance, skewness and kurtosis, process capabilities, what is the process capability index, all the things which is related to design of manufacturing we are going to see. Okay, so when we are going to make for the manufacturer, we are considering already I said tolerances are very important. So the tolerances means it's a permissible deviation which is helpful for the components, okay, whether it we can check whether it is within the limit or not, whether we can accept the component or not. So if not, then we can reject or we can go the reverse and all. So in these cases, process capabilities and the whether the process is under process control or not, how we can find. So here we are having some measurements techniques for the process control. These are all the main measurements techniques for the control of the process. Mean, variance, skewness and kurtosis, or there are some measurements. So mean is, we know, average. So it's a set of data describes the average. The mean is a good measure of central tendency to use. So if you take some measurements of a component, I'm producing a component of 10 plus or minus 0.2, that's a tolerance it is given. So the upper limit is 10.2, lower limit is 9.8. so this is the difference. If you cross these reference, the relation between attainable tolerance and the grades we have seen in this, the what is the specification is some 74.5 plus or minus 0.5. so the lower and upper limit, it will help for the components which is whether it is coming under process or not. So here, if the number of the set we have checked, so the number of set of readings, according to that, the average of that say reading set will give you the mean. And the squared, the expectations of the squared deviation from the random variable, it will give the variance. Okay. So what do you mean by a variance? Variance, how we are going to calculate? Okay. The variance is, first what we have, the formula given is xi by minus the mean of x divided by n minus 1, sum of the things. So the value of one observation, xi refers to the value of one observation, and x mean. So first subtract the mean of each value from the each value. The mean we have to find, mean is the average. So average we have to subtract from the each value and add all the values, and the square of these each we call it as the distance. When we are subtracting value with this mean, we will get the, we call it as a distance each value from the mean. So the distance, when we square the distance, okay, and add all the squares, then divide the sum, the sum of the squares by the number of values in the data set, total number, how much data we have given, 10, if you have taken 10 readings, okay, I am taking 10 number of reading, one is the first value, I second value, third value, that's okay. So here we are calculating, we are finding, for example, if I take a component of a 10 mm diameter, I am measuring 10 times with the instrument, vernier caliper it seems. So the different readings, you will get a different readings, the 10 readings I am taking, and what is the mean of it, number of times I have taken is 10, n is equal to 10, and the mean is divided by 10, whatever the we are getting divided by the 10, we will give the average. So that average we call it as x bar, the mean, arithmetic mean. Okay, now each data minus the arithmetic mean will give the distance from the mean. Can you understand now? So each data what we have taken and subtract that data from the mean, it will give the distance from the mean. So all the data from the mean, we have to take it, add it, and then square it, subtract it by this n minus 1. So we'll give, we get the variance, we call it as a variance. It's mentioned as S square, we will keep it as a square, right? And the skewness, now we will see the skewness. What is a skewness? And that is one type of method of control, or we can check whether the process is in what control. So it's just like a graph. It's a graph. It's made of data points. So you can see when normal distribution, if you see the bell shape curve will come. When here, if you see that the systematic this, if it is both are symmetry or lack of symmetry, we are going to find with the help of the skewness. Skewness is a measure of symmetry. You can see negative and positive skew. One side it is lagging one this direction, and positive side skews is on the right side direction. So when it is common, when it is normal, okay, we will get the exact bell shape of a distribution. But now you can see the data, so whatever I have collected during the measurement, this thing I will put the data in order, so that finally if I get this value, that is which is whether it is between the limits or which is limit or not, so that it will give the skewness in which direction the process is going on. One side, only one side, the distribution is occurs only one side, or right side, or only left side, or say exactly at the center, we come to know with this skewness. Okay, so it will give a approach for us to understand the symmetricity of the symmetry of the distribution of the data. So and this is also like that skewness, a kurtosis, we call it as kurtosis. In this kurtosis, it's a probability theory and statistics. It says the kurtosis is a measure of tailness. So you can see how tail it is. The tailness, if it is a sharp or it is a broader, or it's an, still broader, the broader of the tails, it will shows the kurtosis, what is the stage of this. Okay, now the probability theory of the statistics says the measure of the tailness is a real value random variable. Now we can see in this graph, okay, the three colors, green, red and blue, we have shown the different characteristics. These are different graph shapes what we have observed from the data set. The kurtosis describes the shape of the probability distribution. Now you can see the data, how the data is distributed, whether in a sharp bell, exact bell shape, or the it's get broader area on the tail, or a little broader or more broader. So it's depends upon the graph. We can name it as lepochrotic, mesochrotic and plecrotics. That is blue color, it will say that. You can see this process capability indices as CP and CPK. As I said, a process whether it is under control or not, this is what we want to check with this. Process means any process. You can take lathe machining process, a component we are producing with turning, okay, and the component is getting produced with the same diameter. I am producing the component 10 plus or minus 0.1. okay, the whether the component are getting produced with the same tolerance limit in the machining or not, whether the process is going within the limit or not. So all the things we can check with these process capability indices, and the skewness, kurtosis, all the things are helpful only to under whether the process is going under control or not. You can see in the figure, the left side unstable, not a capable process. So there are two figures we have given here. One is first data, if you see the data, the sample parametric distributions when we have made at different stages, it will show that it is not the process is not in a proper flow. One time it says the distribution is at the center, and next after sometimes if you take some data and if you check the probability distribution curve, it says some it is deviated from so many sides, and the right side you can see it is exactly, it is lying within the specific limits, that is the limit, what upper limit and lower limit we are giving for the product. If all the components, all the distributions are sets within the limit, then it is under control, right? So the process capability indices. And what is process capability? It is the repeatability and the consistency of the manufacturing process related to the customer requirement. As I said, repeatability, number of times if you do it, it is maintaining the same processor, it gets repeated the same. So we call it as the ability of the process to maintain the capable of the process which maintain the limits under control. The process capability expressed with an index, we call it as CP and CPK. Okay, we will start with the CP. The CP and CPK are two major indices. CP, it is a simple process capability index which relates the allowable spread of the spec limit to the measure of the actual. So what is the relationship between CP? Is the relation it relates the allowed specific limits with the actual component measurement. Okay, what we are getting during the actual measurement and what it is allowed. So what is the relation? It shows this, the CP shows this. Okay, and standard deviation, we know already, it's a defined as the root mean square of the deviation from average. Okay, so the CP and CPK, it depends upon standard deviation. That is CP and CPK is calculated, how it is calculated and how the CP is calculated, we will see in the third and fourth point. CP index is calculated using the specification of specification limits and the standard deviation only. Okay, the CPK index is using specification limits, the standard deviation and the arithmetic mean. All the three it needs CPK, CP needs the two is enough. So the formula are there, and for finding the CP, CPK and all with the help of standard deviations and the mean, arithmetic mean, the to calculate it. Next one we are going to see about the cumulative effect of tolerance. In the next video we will go and see.